Subscribe to my channel and press the bell icon to get notified about new videos. Hi friends, this is Mandeep and you are watching High Technology TV. In this video, I will show you how to create a VM instance on Google Cloud. So right now you are into Google Cloud homepage. You can open it by typing cloud.google.com, and on homepage you are able to see that we have a button that try free. So just click on that. And you can check here that it is providing us $300 credit for free, and sign up and get $300 to spend on Google Cloud platform over the next 12 months. And here you can also check that no tow charge after free trial ends. We ask you for your credit card to make sure that you are not a robot. You won't be charged unless you manually upgrade to a paid account. So here we are creating a free account and Google will credit us $300, and we can use them when we create our VM instances, or we can use storage, network and all that. So I have created an account already. You can create. It's a simple step. You just have to choose your country, then acceptance. Then you have to agree to the terms and license. Then you click on agree and continue. And on this page, Google is going to ask us our account type. So here I am going to use the individual. For the tax information, we have to provide that we are in business or what kind. Like if I choose individual here, on the tax status it will ask that we are registered individual or unregistered. So I choose registered one, and now it is going to ask PAN number of ours, and here it will ask for the address and phone number. And here it will ask for the card details. So we have to enter our card detail just to make sure that we are not a robot and we are a human being. And then click on start my free trial. Google will also debit a $0 to $1, between $0 to $1 from your credit card, just to make sure that your card you have entered is working or not, and that will be refunded back. So I have already created an account, so I am just going to log in with that. Also friend, I am masking all my details just for privacy. So once you created the account, Google will set up your dashboard, and here you can see that you have one instance. I have already one instance, and this is my project info, and here you can check your compute engine CPU percentage and all that. So let's straight go to the VM creation. So just go to the compute engine, then click on VM instances. If you are not going to find the compute engine here, you will find it below here. You can find it in the compute section. I have pinned it, that's why it's coming here. So let's create a VM instance. It will open up this page, and here you are able to see that we have an option of create instance. Just click on that. So here I am going to create a Windows instance. So let's create a Windows instance, and here we have to type the name of our instance with lowercase and no space. So just type win 2012 server, and this is our region and this is our zone. So here I'm choosing only, let's take 2 vCPU and 7.5 gigabyte of RAM. If you want to extend, you can extend it, but Google have a limitations of 8 vCPU for a free trial. In the CPU platform, you can choose the automatic, or you can choose Intel Skylake, Broadwell or Haswell or later. So here I am leaving it as default and keeping automatic. On the boot disk part, just click on change, and on the right side Google will open a pane, and here you are able to see that we have multiple OS system. So here I am going to choose the Windows 2012 R2 data center. If you want to choose, you can choose the another one. Let's take a Windows Server 2016 data center, and I am giving it space 50 GB because it is just for demonstration. So click select. Let's make it 2016. Now on the access scope, allow default access, or if you want to choose allow full access to all cloud API or set access for each API. So I'm leaving it allow default access. On the firewall end, if you want to check HTTP and HTTPS traffic, you can check it. Now expand management security, disk and networking part, and now click on the networking, and here on the network part, let we choose default or VNC HANA. I have created a VNC network here, VPC network. Google called it VPC network, so I have created one. So but here I am taking the default one, and sub network for that is by default this, and this is our primary internal IP, and this is our external IP. So external IP is used to take the remote from our machine, so we are taking it. And on the network service tier, if you want to choose the premium, you can choose it, otherwise you can choose standard one. And here you can see the specification of these network service tier. So let's click on done. And if you want to add another disk also, you can add from here. Just click on the disk part and click on add new disk, and here you can add a disk, but here I'm not going to add a new disk. So let's just click on create. Now Google is going to take a few seconds to create our server. Let's wait. Okay, so our Windows 2016 server is now ready, and external IP for that is this. So first of all, let's create a set a password for our Windows. So this is basically our username. So let's go and click on set. And here Google will provide us a password. Just copy that and click on close. Make sure to save this password. So now click on RDP, and here you can connect your Windows server by two ways. Either you have to install Google RDP extension, or you can download the RDP file. So let's download the RDP file. So here is our RDP file, just click on cancel. And here we are going to take the remote desktop of our Windows 2016 server by using MSTSC, Windows by default program. So let's connect. So here it is asking for the password, so just paste the password you have copied and click on remember one and click on OK. So just click yes. So this is our Windows 2016 server we have created, and this is the desktop of the same. And here just go to the Windows Explorer, and here you can see that we have 50 GB of hard disk that we have created. So okay friend, by this way we can create a Windows server in our Google Cloud. One more thing is here that if you are not able to take the remote of your machine, then you have to change the firewall. For that, just go to the firewall and click on firewall rules. On the firewall rules, here you have to look that which network you are using. Here I am using the default one, so here it is already created by Google, that is default allow RDP, and here you can see the port, that is 3389. If you do not have this particular port allowed, then you have to allow it. You can create a firewall rule by just clicking on this particular button and then you can create here. So okay friend, thank you for watching. Please like, share, subscribe my channel. Have a nice day.